Hello everyone, welcome to the webinar on D365 Business Central. We are starting our webinar now. My name is Gaurav Raj, working at Olitech as a principal consultant. This webinar shall take about 45 minutes. For the first 35 minutes, I will cover the overview of Business Central and then take up your questions. Before I move further, a few instructions for you to note. You would see you have a Q&A section, so you can post your questions over there, which I will take up during the end of the session. Over there you see two tabs, one is for presentation, one is for QA. To view the actual size and a fit to screen, you can use actual size option, and please do not request for the control during the webinar. Thank you. So what is all the excitement about Business Central and why? In this webinar, I'll cover the reasons and the topics in line. Microsoft D365 is a set of business applications that are changing how the organizations work. And the recent excitement has been the release of Business Central as part of D365 solution stack. Finally, we have the ERP on cloud for SMB segment, which has modern and updated UI elements that give you a refreshing look, layout, and navigation across all devices, be it on mobile, web, or a web tablet client. This view shows the menu in Business Central being moved to the top ribbon with easy and quick access to all major functions in Business Central. The view now shows you the dashboard for a user on Business Central, which helps you to identify the actionable items like overdue sales invoices, payment predictions, and pending user tasks, all from within the user dashboard. The next one is an intuitive and impressive tile view of the item master, along with its Power BI report at the right side. The next one is an extended view of the item, with a modern way to browse through records. Notice the navigation buttons on the screen. In Business Central, the user experience is same across all devices. Now you can enable your workforces to work on the go. Business Central offers a unified experience by seamlessly integrating it with other Microsoft Business applications like D365 for Sales, which is actually MS CRM, Office 365, Excel, Outlook, and other applications, Product BI, Power Apps, and Flows, increasing the productivity, process automation, and efficiency. Business Central leverages the power of intelligent cloud to provide an actionable insight for decision makers. The intelligent cloud insight page in Business Central shows the KPI charts along with insights into potential areas of concern. That is what you see at the right side. And the embedded Power BI reports. Business Central is highly adaptable. It can be configured to customize to meet your specific business requirements. This is done either by installing customizations through extensions or else by installing pre-built solutions. Those are available on the Microsoft App Store, which you can search through. Now let's dive into the details to understand what makes Business Central a must-go ERP solution for SMB segment. Everyone would agree that cloud is a fundamental enabler of digital transformation. The most successful businesses are already reaping the rewards by expanding on flexible cloud platforms. On similar lines, Business Central inherits the capabilities of Microsoft's Azure Cloud, which lets you do away with the challenges of procuring and managing IT infra. Hence, no need to manage backups, failovers, storage, and manpower. Integrated with other Azure components like DevOps, Big Data and Analytics, Modern Data Warehouse, and Business Intelligence. Microsoft provides a 30 days free trial instance of Business Central, which can later be converted to production instance from your O365 account. So you can decide to start small and grow big. Azure facilitates free version upgrades on Business Central. Another capability with Business Central that one should look at is its analytics and AI capabilities, like sales and inventory forecasting, late payment predictions, cash flow forecasting, and intelligent KPI using inbuilt Power BI reports. Let me take you through a few screenshots to understand these. The screenshot here is the dashboard for a business manager. It shows his KPIs as a Power BI report. The manager can run it for different periods and browse through multiple PI reports from his dashboard. The screenshot appearing now shows a dashboard with cash flow forecast along with the customer cash cycle and activity tiles. If you notice, the cash cycle is a Power BI report. The screenshots here shows intuitive set of Power BI reports on Power BI dashboard for the business manager. It will help the manager easily identify key customers, items, and the sales trend to make key business decisions. The next one shows how Business Central helps in payment prediction for customer invoices. Notice the highlighted area. With edit in Excel and open in Excel options, user can readily update the data in Excel and push it back to Business Central. Optimize stock levels and avoid lost sales. This is done by using the built-in intelligence of item availability and sales and inventory forecast apps available as extensions from Microsoft. The scheme how if when you open the item master or the item card on Business Central, the forecast shows up in the fact box on the right side. Boost sales and customer service productivity. That is another important point. Act quickly on sales-related inquiries, manage service requests, and process payments all from within Outlook. The screenshot now shows you Outlook with an email coming from a prospect or maybe a customer asking for a quote, and he has listed just the item, the product description, and the quantities. On the right side, you see another area which looks to be from the Business Central, as the name goes. It not only so what happens when an email is received from anyone, Business Central readily identifies if this based on this email ID whether this person is an existing customer or not, or is this just a contact or as a prospect. If it is a customer, Business Central finds out what has been the history, the transaction history, and the business that we have been running with this customer. As you can see, it is showing you the details, the payments outstanding, and what are the number of orders which we are running with this customer. Here is an extended view of the same screen. So as you see, somebody has written, please send me a quote for 25 Dell ProBook 910 laptops. It is such a casual way to ask for a quote in single line. However, Business Central was still able to identify that this person is nothing but an existing customer in Business Central. The name is Olitech, and here is the transactional history and the sales history. So there are already some transactions in the system, and there's a sales outstanding in the system. Now, who is doing all this? A salesperson, maybe a customer service person, who is working on his Outlook interface and not on Business Central. So he's working right within the Outlook screen. So what happens now? Well, that's not the end of the story. Business Central from here identifies what reads through the email, identifies the item and the quantity he has been talking about, And the screenshot, as you see, Business Central is suggesting the user that, hey, I have identified the item from this email, and I think that this item is nothing but item number 1000. And it also identifies how much quantity are we talking about. Now, considering the scenario, we have already set up item prices in Business Central. So basis that, what Business Central will do, will create right from within the Outlook, it will create a sales code or maybe a sales order based on the user wish. And then a user from Outlook can prepare the sales code and sales order as PDF and send it to the customer. Let's talk about the key features which makes Business Central stand out. To name a few, quick and predefined way of importing opening balances. Business Central has created an out-of-the-box feature on the journals if you want to do it yourself and import the opening balances. Start with Business Central and import the opening balances as a template. The feature is available to you already. Single-click reversal and collection of posted invoices. So from the posted invoices, you can browse through the posted invoices and choose to reverse the posted invoice, or maybe reverse and then post a corrected posted invoice in the system. That is all available through a single click. About workflow, define your approval workflow. Now, that is a very important point because workflow has been there in the NAB version also. You can define workflow on masters like item vendors. You can define workflow on documents like sales documents, purchase documents. Moreover, you can also configure and define workflow approvals for the journals. It could be expense journals, as salary journals, or you know, payment journals. In addition to that, Business Central also provides you how you can manage the services from the item master. So an item can be defined as service on the item card. That is an out-of-the-box feature available with Business Central. Employee ledger. There have always been a challenge with maintaining and managing the employee statements. They were either being set up as vendors or dimensions in the system. However, now you have a full-fledged entity for employee ledger, so you can generate a statement, do the reconciliation and application, just like you do it for a vendor. User tasks. A very good feature, new feature added in Business Central, and quite useful for managers or even users. Anybody who is using Business Central, they can create and assign tasks from either mobile or web. Consider a scenario where a finance manager or a sales manager is traveling and in his mind, he finds that there is something that he wants any other person in the office to do. So from his mobile, he can set up or create a user task and assign it to the person. The person and the manager can readily monitor the progress and the completion of the task. Pre-configured Excel reports. Business Central provides a set of pre-configured Excel reports which can be run on a single click. For example, business balance sheet, income statement, cash flow statement, retained earnings, fund balance, ledger accounts receivable and payable, which allows you to dynamically do a data filtering right from within the Excel, and it is real time connected to the Business Central data. You can design reports in Power BI and embed in Business Central in simple steps. That is another feature that you would get with Business Central. Apart from these, Business Central provides you handful assisted setup wizards for guided setup. The question you would have is, how would the customizations be done in Business Central? And the answer is extensions. Custom applications and functionalities are built as L extensions. No more customizations using Kel code. That was how all the customizations were done in the previous version of NAV. All customizations and add-on solutions are designed in L and deployed as extensions, or you can call them packages, which can be installed, uninstalled, or unpublished. The screenshot here shows the dashboard in Business Central to manage the extensions in manage the extensions. It shows the extensions which are currently installed and also an option to upload extensions and to search them over the extension marketplace. Microsoft has a complete app store market marketplace for extension, which has numerous apps to choose from that suits the specific business requirement. A lot of free extension apps are already available on App Store Marketplace from Microsoft, and these are free to install, set up, and use. As shown in the slide here, there are apps available for data migration from Solimon, Great Plains, QuickBooks, and also an app for Microsoft Pay. In fact, a lot of third-party application providers had provided their connectors as app on the App Store. No need to buy licenses for objects, with, for example, tables, forms, and report objects. So you are free to use any number of objects in the custom object range. Going further, Microsoft aims to release country localizations as extensions in future, simplifying the localizations. What should be our considerations for upgrade, and what would be the process if we choose to do so? That is another question in our mind. An upgrade is inevitable. If one chooses to continue with NAV as their business application, they have to decide to upgrade. The earlier versions of NAV are moving out of Microsoft support, even extended support. Once you are on Business Central, all future upgrades and cumulative updates are done automatically by Microsoft and are free. Microsoft plans to release 2 major updates per year. And above all, adoption of cloud, AI, analytics, and interoperability. These are the steps towards digital transformation. And the most likely next question would be about data migration. How do we get our data migrated from current NAV to Business Central? I will spend next couple of minutes speaking about this. The data migration is done using configuration packages to migrate data to Business Central. This is applicable for masters and openings, providing a clean start with Business Central. In case of an on-premise or a hybrid deployment, there is an option to migrate historical data. In few cases, data migration extension is available to migrate data from a non-NAV application. Talking about the process, what all does the upgrade process involves? Identification, the first one would be the identification of redundant customizations and custom features to be dropped off. Then comes assessment for compatibility of custom Kel code with L extensions. Here, Olitech's dimmest utility simplifies the process of assessment. Here, what you see is the screenshot of the DMIST app, the result from the DMIST app or utility. It basically by object type, it is comparing how many are the base objects. For example, you are working with an existing version of NAV, which could be any version, 2013 or 2016, and it identifies first of all the base objects, the custom objects, the new objects, and the modified objects. Based on that, it identifies how many are the clean objects, which means that they can easily be converted to L extensions 2.0 without any issues. It also identifies, and that's what you see as the suspect objects, which will not get converted to extensions and will need manual intervention and effort. Based on this, it shows the score and an effort estimation to convert these suspect objects into L extensions. Very easily, you can see how much would be my total effort, right? And also, here is a breakdown of a graphical view of that. So this is how you understand the score. If it is score is 90%, greater than 90%, it implies that it will take less effort, which means low effort and low risk. If your score is 60 to 89%, it implies that it will take moderate amount of effort in conversion and a moderate risk. Less than 50, which means that there is significant effort required for converting your custom code to extensions. High effort and high risk. After this, having all this analysis, you can now start the project. All right. So I will now open the forum for Q&A. All right, so I see a question. Is the licensing for NAV same as or it is different in D365 Business Central? That's a valid question. It is different. In NAV you enjoy the perpetual license, which was concurrent. However, with D365 Business Central, you have the named user licensing concept. With the cloud option. However, if you go with the hybrid installation or deployment for D365, then you have the option to have a perpetual license. However, it is again all of these licensings are named user based. Any other question? Another question I see, can I customize D365 Business Central? Yeah, definitely and obviously. With the new extensions model, you can do all the customizations. However, the extensions take care of the standard code. So there is no chance that you can change the standard code, but you have to write your own extensions and events to make that specific business change happen in the system. Is there a demo environment available? Yeah, very much. Microsoft is providing you a trial instance that you can configure using your O365 account, and it runs for 30 days. So it is a free 30 days trial. What about the updates, the platform updates for Business Central, cloud, and on-premise? Right. Those are so the answer is that you get an automatic and free upgrade happening on when you are using Business Central on cloud. However, on-premise, it is the responsibility of the partner and the customer to deploy these updates and releases. Okay, how to upgrade from NAV to Business Central online? Well, I think I covered that in one of the slides. You have to use the configuration packages through which you can migrate your masters and your opening data. So that is how you can start with the business center on a clean slate. Is comparison between objects is manual? Okay, so I think another question, comparison between objects is manual. So if you're talking about while you are converting or when you're doing the conversion to extensions at that time, you can use, you can take the advantage of PowerShell or else it has to be manual. But anyways, you have to write the code in as L extensions. Is there no way we can move same as normal upgrades? On-premise option, you have a toolkit available from Microsoft using which you can do a complete data migration with historical data from your earlier NAV to Business Central. And once if you choose to be on online, it is a different way, but on on-premise, yes, you can do a full data upgrade just like a normal upgrade. So there is a toolkit available. How to upgrade NAV licenses to Business Central licenses? Is there a change in licensing model? Yes, there is definitely a change in licensing model. I think I covered that already. The licensing in Business Central is named user based. It is not concurrent in Business Central. However, you can choose on a pay-as-you-go model when you are on cloud. In case you go for on-premise installation, then you have the perpetual. The chart you showed for object comparison is by system or manual? Well, the chart which I showed for object comparison, it is a proprietary of Polytech, and the tool is called DMIST. So that was an output of our Polytech's tool called DMIST. And or I would say not tool, but utility called DMIST, which does the comparison on its own, and it has called the intelligence built in. Intelligent cloud option, definitely the third one is the hybrid upgrade. So you have three options, the cloud, which is pay as you go, then on-premise, and the third one is a hybrid with an intelligent cloud. So intelligent cloud provides you the benefit of on-premise installation. On top of it, you get the benefits of the cloud installation. So ultimately, if you migrate from NAV, any version of NAV to on-premise, so your data is completely migrated. And once you enable it for a hybrid mode, then your data is completely migrated and you are on cloud also. However, the going online, how do you convert it to a truly online licensing? That is a different thing. And there is no clarity from Microsoft on that. How to move custom fields, tables, data? Right, so you have to write the configuration packages for these. So the question was, how can we move the data which is lying in my custom tables and fields to Business Center Online? So you have to write, you have to do it through the configuration packages, or else you can use the edit in Excel. A lot of information we have shared in the blogs on our website, olitech.com. Apart from that, you can also send us and write us on info@olitech.com, and we'll definitely be helping you with your questions. Thank you, everyone. I hope the webinar was helpful. Please do write back to us at info@olitech. And after this session, we'll be sharing you the link for webinar. Thank you, everyone.